Hello, my dear children of class 11 science. Today again I welcome all of you through this mode of teaching as we are following already, that is called YouTube mode. And in today's class again we do continue with the chapter that you are learning in the last class, that is flow of liquids. And in today's class we complete this chapter, okay, with the theory part of this chapter. Okay, now the last topic that we discuss in today's class, this is an important topic, okay, which is important not only with your exams, for examination, and is equally important for your competitive exams also. Okay, and the topic that we are going to learn is called velocity of efflux of a liquid, and this is actually based on a theorem that is called Torricelli's theorem. Now in the last class, if you remember, we discussed in details about the application. We are learning the application of Bernoulli's theorem. In that particular application we discuss in details about the instrument or device that is called venturimeter. Okay, and that venturimeter actually works on the principle of Bernoulli's theorem. But there is another application that can also be used of Bernoulli's theorem is to determine the velocity of the flow of any liquid from a very very small hole, and this hole is also called orifice. Okay, and this particular flow of any liquid, okay, through a very small hole or narrow opening, okay, when the liquid contained in a vessel, is actually called as velocity of efflux. Now the velocity of efflux of liquid is also determined by using a Bernoulli's theorem. Okay, so we find the Bernoulli's theorem application even in this particular topic. Okay, but this Bernoulli's application is actually explained in the form of theorem, and that was proposed by Torricelli, so one of the scientists, okay, who actually made one of the simple barometer to measure the atmospheric pressure also. Okay, now the word efflux means flowing out. What? Outflow. We can also use the word outflow. So let me just write the point. So as I said already, the word efflux means outflow. Okay, out the flow out from something. Okay, but the flow of what? Flowing out of what? Basically liquid. It can be a gas also, but we deal out with the liquid. Okay, from a very very small hole, a very 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 small hole, that is called narrow opening. And this small hole or narrow opening also called orifice. And children, you know very well, you have done in a common experience also, that you take, when we take a vessel containing water, okay, but if you make a very small hole, okay, at any height on the vessel, okay, then what happens? We start seeing that there is a water coming out from that vessel, okay, and that water which flow out definitely had a certain velocity, and that the flowing of water from that small hole with a certain velocity is actually measured as the velocity of efflux of a liquid. But we deal basically with the liquid like water, because water is one of the common liquid. But this velocity of efflux can be applied for any liquid. What? Any liquid. But out here we deal basically with what? Water. But to calculate by what velocity the liquid flow out, okay, from that small hole, okay, is actually determined by using a Bernoulli's theorem. So even in this particular topic also, the theorem that we apply is called Bernoulli's theorem. That's why, children, one of the important theorem for the flow of liquid is concerned is called Bernoulli's theorem. Now let me consider a vessel. So you can see already in the diagram, this is a vessel, okay, with a very small hole which I have already made. But let me just consider there is no hole at this part, okay. So let me just fill with water in this vessel. So let me just fill the water in the vessel up to this height. Suppose there is a water which is filled in a vessel up to certain height. So this is all liquid like water. So I just assume that there is no hole which has been made in the vessel. So this is completely a vessel, okay, containing liquid like water. Okay, and this surface where the liquid aqua in a vessel is also called free surface. This is also called what surface? Free surface. This surface of the liquid is also called free surface. Okay, now what happens as soon as when you make a small hole, that is also called orifice, okay, at a certain height from on the vessel, we see that there is a water which come out from the from that hole, and water flow exactly in following a certain path, and it falls this way. So water will not come out this way. So water will come out with a certain velocity, okay, following a certain path. And this path in which the water flows out is basically called as parabolic path. What path? Parabolic path. Okay. It's just like a motion occurred by the water. It will be like what motion? Projectile motion. And you know projectile motion is a two-dimensional motion. And that is also called motion in a plane. Okay. But we are basically concerned out here with by what velocity the water flow out from this orifice. Okay. And what is the distance, the range in which the water falls on the ground from this height, that we need to determine. Okay. But before that, let me just consider that there is a water which is already acquiring a height from the bottom of the vessel. And that height of water I consider is say H. What height? Capital H. So the vessel containing water, and in that vessel the water acquire a height, and that height is what? Capital H. So you can see the diagram. So capital H is the height of the liquid. Like we are taking liquid, any liquid, it's not only water, it can be any liquid. Okay, it is the height of the liquid containing in a vessel. So what is the height I've considered? Capital H. So capital H, as I said already, it is the height of liquid filled in a what? Vessel. Now when I make a small orifice, this is called orifice, okay, orifice, which is also called a very small hole, like opening, narrow opening, where the water come out. Okay, if I make this orifice from the free surface, then this orifice also acquire a height from the free surface. Also we call the depth from the free surface, and that is equals to H. That is equals to what? H. That means there is a small orifice which is made at a depth from the free surface of the liquid. So this is from the free surface, and this orifice is made at a depth of H from the free surface of the liquid. Now usually what happened in this case, that the liquid experience what pressure? Atmospheric pressure at the free surface. So that atmospheric pressure at the free surface I consider as P. So if P is the atmospheric pressure experienced by the liquid at the free surface, then the same atmospheric pressure also experienced by the liquid when it coming flow out from this orifice. Okay, that means there is atmospheric pressure at this point also. At this point also, and that pressure is also P. Because atmospheric pressure at this free surface and this narrow opening will also remain same. Okay, and that atmospheric pressure I consider as what? P. So let P be the what? Atmospheric pressure. So what is capital P? Is the atmospheric pressure exerted on the liquid, exerted on the liquid at what? Free surface, at free surface and at orifice. So this atmospheric pressure will try to make the liquid to push down to the bottom. Okay, and the, due to that atmospheric pressure only the liquid will come out from the orifice. But when the liquid come out from this orifice, okay, so definitely liquid come out with a certain velocity, and that velocity is called the velocity of efflux, and we need to calculate that velocity. Now the height in which the liquid come out from this orifice from the bottom of the vessel can be calculated also. This height is H, capital H, and this is the depth is H, small h. So this height will be H, capital H minus small h. So look at the diagram, children. So the height in which the liquid fall out, come out from this orifice, from the bottom of the vessel will be H minus, capital H minus small h. Now the next part that we need to understand in this particular diagram is that this liquid containing in this vessel, okay, acquire different energies. Okay, and as per the Bernoulli's theorem, you know that the total energy per unit volume of a liquid is always remain what? Constant. Okay, so at this height, capital H, the liquid acquire the energies. The liquid acquire what? Energies. Now height is already acquired by the liquid, so that it has what energy? Potential energy. Okay, so there is also a pressure exerted on a unit volume of the liquid. That means there is a pressure energy also. But it is considered that the kinetic energy of the liquid at the free surface is basically zero. because the liquid on the free surface basically remains at what? Rest. Initially remains at what? Rest. Now why it happens, I'll tell you afterwards, okay. But just telling you that there is an energy, okay, which is acquired by the liquid at the free surface. One is called pressure energy, and this is the pressure energy due to atmospheric pressure. Then there is a height acquired by the liquid, which is called potential energy. And there is no kinetic energy acquired by the liquid at the free surface. Okay. Now, at the same time, when liquid come out from this orifice, at this height also, there is an energy acquired by the liquid. One is pressure energy, the atmospheric pressure, the height, potential energy, and the liquid which is coming out with a certain velocity even has what energy? Kinetic energy. So that the total energy of the liquid at this free surface and the orifice will always remain constant. And that is according to what? Bernoulli's theorem. Now children, before I apply Bernoulli's theorem in this particular case, let me do the assumption. And this is very important part because I have said already the velocity of liquid, okay, at the free surface is zero. That means the liquid is basically remains at free surface. But this cannot be considered like that only. So for that, there is some consideration we need to do it. And this consideration is based on the principle of continuity. Okay, the principle of continuity. So let me just apply principle of continuity. Now, because the volume of water, okay, the volume of water of the liquid flowing per second in this free surface down will be equal to the volume of the same liquid which will flow out from this orifice in how many second? 1 second. Means the rate of flow of liquid in 1 second at this free surface is exactly equal to the rate of flow of liquid, okay, in 1 second from this end. So this is according to principle of continuity. So with this, I can make a relation. But for that relation, I have already assumed that B1, I've already assumed that B1 is the velocity of liquid at free surface, at this free surface. Now I consider that this free surface has an area, say, A1. Just assuming that this free surface has area what? A1. And in this free surface, I assume that the liquid which is flowing with a velocity, how much? B1. Now, next, we have another surface that is called orifice, where the area I have considered as A2. But at this orifice also, the velocity in which is coming out is how much? B2. So these are the velocity of the liquid at free surface and orifice of area A1 and A2. So as I said already, according to principle of continuity, the velocity of liquid flowing per second at this free surface and this orifice will exactly the same. So I write down from principle of continuity. This is from principle of what? Continuity. So if I use principle of continuity, then I can write down A1 B1 equals to A2 B2. Yes, you have learned this relation. A1 B1 equals to A2 B2. Means the product of area, okay, at free surface and the velocity of liquid which is flowing at the free surface must be equals to, in 1 second, equals to area at the orifice into the velocity of liquid which is flowing at this orifice in how many seconds? 1 second. Okay. So A1 B1 equals to A2 B2. So let me just make the subject out here. If I make A1 B1 equals to A2 B2, then I write down B1 by B2 equals to A2 by what? A1. So just making the ratio that B1 by B2 will go in the denominator equals to A2 by A1. Now this principle of continuity which I am applying out here is basically to assume that the water or liquid will be at rest at this free surface only when we assume certain condition. And the condition that we are going to apply out here is that this orifice means a small hole even has an area, and that area is what? A2. But if I consider this area of this orifice is very, very, very small as compared to area what? Of this free surface. Yes, because this hole on any opening which is considered has an area. But if I consider this orifice or hole has a very small area, that is A2, as compared to A1, then this A2 can be neglected. But according to principle of continuity, as you know that smaller the area, by more velocity the liquid flows. Okay, but this relation says that if A2 is very less compared to A1, so A1 is neglected, means A2 by A1 is equal to zero. So if this neglected means this is almost equals to 0. And 0 divided by anything is what? 0. So if A2 by A1 is 0, then B1 by B2 is 0. So in the expression, B2 cannot be 0 because it's flowing out from the liquid. So if B2 is not 0, it means definitely B1 is 0. B1 is what? 0. So children, look at the expression. This B1 means the velocity of liquid at the free surface will assume to be 0 only, means this free surface is remaining at rest. Okay, only when we take a orifice or very small area, which is less compared to the area of what surface? Free surface. That means we assume this concern. Now, under this situation, we can assume that the free surface is basically at rest. That means the velocity is what? 0. But this is true, as I said, only when this orifice has a very small what? Area. So this is the assumption that we need to do it. So children, I have just made the first part of this topic where what assumption and all we have to make and which theorem we need to apply and what are the different part in the liquid flows and all, okay, and how the pressure exerted. Now, in the next YouTube video, means the continuation of this topic only, I'll do with the expression of the velocity of efflux that can be determined, okay, by using which theorem? Bernoulli's theorem. And that I do continue next YouTube video.